Hello and welcome to Contact. Today we're continuing the series we started last week called Miracles Happen, with a message on how we can change the expected results of many things in our lives through the power that's been given to us through Christ. So today our message is changing outcomes.
Right. So instead of just the same expectation of everything being the same and just continuing on, you know, which people get used to, what miracles do, it's really an intervention in our lives of supernatural proportion that changes the outcome of everything.
Yeah, if you're not willing to accept life as usual, situations as usual, then you have an option. You have the power of God working with you to change outcomes. So stick with us. We'll be right back.
If I'm giving my all to anything, I'm giving my all to
what's up, it's your boy Aaron Cole. I'm coming to a big night in RVA. I'm coming to Richmond, Virginia for New Year's Eve, man. We bringing in the new year and VA, two up, two down. I can't wait to see you there. It's going to be free for youth and young adults, food, games, and more. So if you want more information, go to faithlandmarks.org. I can't wait to see you there. Peace.
For a church that's active, engaged in outreach, and based on the biblical foundations of God's Word? If so, then Faith Landmarks Ministries is not only that, but much more. For over 35 years, Faith Landmarks Ministries has been teaching the Word of God, training up disciples, and expanding the kingdom. Through the fivefold vision God has given to Pastors Randy and Cherie, we make it our mission to fulfill the Great Commission that Jesus commanded in His Word. We invite you to come worship, receive, and fellowship with like-minded believers every Sunday morning at 8:30 and 10:30 a.m., Sunday evenings at 7 p.m., and Wednesdays at 7:30 p.m. Check out our website at faithlandmarks.org and view recent messages, see upcoming events, download study materials, and much more. You can also stay connected with us via any of our social media services. We invite you to come experience real, undoctrinated Christianity, where the Word of God is brought to life in you. We look forward to seeing you here at Faith Landmarks Ministries.
God is good. Okay, so Acts, Book of Acts, chapter 8, verse 39. It says, "And when they were come up out of the water," now I'm breaking into the middle of a story, and I'm going to tell you a lot of the story today. There's a story in the Book of Acts about Philip. You know, a lot of our attention often goes to the story around Peter, or the story around Saul, who became the Apostle Paul. Okay, but this time it's a one chapter event with a few added verses later on. This is the story of Philip. Okay, so we're jumping into the middle of his story. When they were come up out of the water, remember Philip had, if you back up into the eighth chapter, Philip was actually a table waiter in the church in Jerusalem. He was originally chosen and appointed. I'm going to read that to you in just a moment. He was chosen and appointed to be one of the people who would help to serve the widows' tables. Now, what they were doing, obviously, was in Jerusalem, is they were taking care of their own, okay, which were the widows in the camp. And apparently there was a lot more of that in those days than there is today. Okay. But, you know, people today depend on Social Security, which is a government thing. Ooh, that didn't go over real big. Hallelujah. But at any rate, Philip was chosen. He was one of the seven, which we will see. He was chosen out of the group to be one of the men. It says they had to be full of wisdom and of the Holy Ghost because they were dealing with a strife situation. There was a strife that broke out between one group of widows and another group of widows. Not unlike the kind of strifes that you see today, which you can select yourself out of. I'm going to show you how to do that. You can actually just walk away. Don't have to entangle yourself. Glory to God. God is good. It's refreshing. All right. So at any rate, Philip, there was a persecution that came on the church in Jerusalem. That's right at the end. And it's about when Stephen was stoned. That's chapter 7. Okay. And persecution came on the church, and many of the believers that were there left. Now, that was not particularly a bad thing in the fact that they took the gospel with them. That's how one of the ways that the church in Antioch was formed were by the people that left the strife. Now what they were doing in Jerusalem is they were killing each other. Hallelujah. So at any rate, Philip, right in the middle of all the mayhem, Philip, being a table waiter, now remember he was filled with the Holy Ghost, he went down to Samaria to preach Christ unto them. Now Samaria was the place that Jewish people didn't go. It would have been the equivalent of a ghetto today or a shanty town. Okay, because the Samaritans were considered, and you should, this is what generates the strife. So there was a strife there between them, and every now and then it broke out. But at any rate, Philip went down to Samaria because Christ had not been preached there yet. Now, technically, they were a part of the nation of Israel. I don't want to get into the long history of it, but at any rate, Samaritans were looked down on. That's the reason why Jesus used the Good Samaritan to point out that not all Samaritans, you know, I mean, God uses Samaritans too. That was the thing. Hallelujah. But Philip went down to Samaria to preach Christ unto them, and they came to the Lord. It was like a big outpouring, healings, salvation, demons cast out, lots of water baptism, but the Holy Ghost had not come on them yet because he didn't preach the Holy Ghost. Okay, now that's the message is not about that. Okay, but then Peter and John went down to Samaria because they had not yet received the Holy Ghost. That's all in the previous verses. Okay. And so then after that is when, after the local people there got saved and filled with the Holy Ghost and had the demons cast out of them and they were healed. This is all in Samaria. Then God led Philip away again. Praise the Lord. And he was on this road, and the Lord said it was going from Jerusalem down to Gaza, and it says it was desert there. Okay, you could go back there today, and, you know, the natural features of the land are such that there's like one side of the eye, of a mountain can be green, the other side can be a desert because of the Mediterranean Sea. All right. So, but in other words, you can find that spot today. But Philip was coming down to Gaza, which like right now is the land of the Philistines. Oh, that didn't go over real big. But that's what they call it. Because, anyway, oh, hallelujah. See how much division there is in people's thinking? Yeah, see, people are divided against each other. This is a sign of the times that we're living in. Okay, so at any rate, Philip was on that road, and there was this Ethiopian eunuch. Now, Ethiopia is also in the news structure of today because they've been having a war. Some inside story on that. There's a group of Christians in Ethiopia. There's also a group of the nation of Israel, which is the reason why the Ethiopian eunuch, see, there was a point when the Jews fled and they went to Ethiopia and started there, living there. And they would come back to Jerusalem to worship. So this was the Ethiopian eunuch. So in other words, he was like a high-ranking official in the court of the queen, king, down there. Hallelujah. And he was coming back from Jerusalem. He had one of the scrolls. Turns out it was the book of Isaiah. He was reading it aloud as he went along. Philip heard that and he said, well, do you want somebody to explain that to you? Because he knew that all this Jewish Enoch knew, eunuch, all that he knew was the Jewish side of it, which is who the letter originally was written to, Isaiah. Now, how many of you have ever read the book of Isaiah? Okay, it was not written to you. It was written for you. That's a perfect example of that. But, you know, we spend a lot of time in the book of Isaiah. It's one of the, I mean, just really a wonderful treatise, if you will, among other things. Many, many promises for the church in there. So at any rate, Isaiah chapter 53 is the passage that shows where Jesus died at Calvary and where healing was paid for. Okay, and remember, the Ethiopian eunuch, all he knew was the Jewish side of the story, the interpretation. And so Philip said, do you want me or do you want somebody to interpret this for you? And so his answer was, well, I don't have anybody to explain it to me. So the Holy Ghost moved on Philip to get up into his chariot and began to explain about Christ. See, he used that passage to preach Jesus to him. Now remember, he was Jewish by mentality, by training, everything. And so as he's hearing this, he realized, well, I believe that. So they happened to be passing by. I'm getting ready to pick up with the story here. They passed by a certain water, meaning like probably a pond or a lake or something of that nature. Okay. And, he said, well, what prohibits me from being baptized? And this is a very good answer for today, too. If you believe with all your heart, then you may be baptized in water. Now, baptism, water baptism in today's world has become something that was not originally intended either. Ooh, that didn't go over real. I don't even know if it reached the back. Yeah, being baptized in water is not going to save you. Calvary is what saves you. What Jesus did for you at Calvary. Hallelujah. All right, so when they were come up out of the water, this is after he was baptized, the Spirit of the Lord caught away Philip, that the eunuch saw him no more, and he went on his way rejoicing. So the eunuch is just all of a sudden Philip was not there. Okay, but the eunuch, you know, he was saved now. Okay, and he that was exciting. Okay, then verse 40, but Philip was found in Azotus, and passing through, he preached in all the cities till he came to Caesarea. So you can find that place most likely on a Bible map. But Azotus was a coastal type of a city. So there was a road that went from Gaza to Caesarea. And so Philip preached his way up. That's the interpretation of what's going on there. Are you there? How many of you are in the story? Now, Philip is shown to us to be a normal Christian person. He was saved and filled with the Holy Ghost. He operated in the gifts of the Spirit. He went to Samaria, preached Christ to them. They got saved. Remember, he was a table waiter in the church in Jerusalem. So he was like a deacon who went preaching. But what you find, look back at verse 26. It says, and the angel of the Lord spake unto Philip. Now, this is where we break in today's world. See, the church has been robbed. And today, the voice of the church prohibits people from having interlude with the Holy Ghost, angels. Okay, but that did not exist with Philip. So Philip was a spirit-filled believer. Angel of the Lord spake to Philip. Okay, so yourself and myself, you should not consider it to be a strange and an unusual thing for angels to be involved in your personal life. Okay, this was an occurrence. Look at verse 29, another one there. And the Spirit said, Philip, go near and join yourself to the chariot. Okay, hallelujah. Now, here's a little thing for you. Inside of all of that is the working of Philip's will. You know, man has a will. So it's obvious in all that we've heard about Philip, book of Acts chapter 6, chapter 8, everything that we've heard about him, he chose to go along with it. Okay, which means that you know, God was able to use him. Okay, but now we're going to dial you in. Because Philip, not unlike Enoch of the Old Testament. See, what the Bible says about Enoch was that he walked with the Lord and he was not. So in other words, Enoch was raptured, you could call it, translated out. And he, you know, he never came back except to appear with Moses to Jesus on the Mount of Transfiguration. Okay, but remember the Apostle Paul describes when he got saved, the Holy Ghost worked with him for a little bit in Arabia, but then he was taken up into the heavenlies and saw things that he couldn't even talk about, he said. That's in 2 Corinthians chapter 12. Lord God, are you out there? Yeah. Now, so what is next to come in the believers of today? And so if you're wondering, where am I going in all of this? Well, you're Philip. You know, you're filled with the Holy Ghost. You're getting people saved. You're operating in the things of God. You're probably praying with people. You're probably casting out devils. Are you there? Okay, but and Philip was doing all of that successfully. But then all of a sudden, wow, he is caught away. Now that phrase caught away is a Greek word which is used in numerous places in the scripture to talk about the rapture. What it really means is to be robbed. Welcome back. Just again, we're just really glad that you're with us today on Contact. So we're talking about changing outcomes. So if you understand the nature of change, it will help you to accept the intervention of miracles. Praise the Lord. Now, this entire message is really a picture of people who their lives were changed, and it was an intervention, and then it turned out differently. And so, which means that, wow, you know, you can't go back and do it a different way. It's going to happen another way.
Yeah, you can't fix the past. I like what somebody said, even God can't change the past. So if we can't change the past, but we don't like the direction things are heading in, and we've had a shock, you know, then you go to God. We've got angels on assignment to assist us, which is what happened with Philip. Mm-hmm. You know, and all believers, the Bible says, the angels are ministering spirits,
yeah,
who actually attend us, and they prevent, you know, accidents. They protect us. They assist us when we employ them with our faith and our prayers to help us in the supernatural realm. So these things are all tools that are available to us in the kingdom of God. And so every believer has a part to play in the kingdom of God. We've each been given a measure of grace in order to carry out that function. And so we're just so excited that you've been able to join us and learn some of these things on Contact. And right here at Contact and Faith Landmarks, we're preparing for a supernatural thing. We're preparing for an unsurpassed year of souls saved and lives changed. We encourage you to get connected with our ministry by partnering with Contact. Visit contact.tv and click on the partnership tab if you want to get involved. And you can do that today. We can also invite you to invest in your spiritual development by becoming a student at Faith Landmarks Bible Institute. You can join anytime online, learn at your own pace by visiting our website at faithlandmarks.org or flbi.org. Our Bible school is fully accredited and a means that we use to train disciples of Christ and church leaders all over the world. Portions of your Contact giving actually help provide our Bible school students materials around the globe free of charge, and is helping to fulfill the Great Commission in the earth.
Right.
Yeah.
Because once they get trained and filled with the word, then they go out and start expanding the kingdom and reaching people. So we have a lot of events and outreaches coming up this calendar year. So you can get involved. We encourage you to check back frequently to faithlandmarks.org to check with the events and the latest projects and things that you can get involved in. We'd love to have you along on some of our trips, some of the things that we do. If that's not something that will work with you, you can be involved by sowing a financial seed. So you can also take a minute there on the same websites to see how you can connect with the vision to reach people with the gospel simply by sowing a financial seed. You know, in today's world, it's become so much easier to do all of this.
Yeah. So just take a few minutes to look at what we've been doing and what you can look forward to coming up.
Let me tell you my testimony. It came without a warning. Started in my head, then it hit me in the heart. My chains started shaking, my soul started waking. I felt your joy breaking down my door. Now I'm so grateful for all that you've done. You've been so faithful, like the rising sun. A new start you've given me, a promise to never leave you. Are faithful, faithful Lord, I'm grateful for you. If I'm giving my all to anything, I'm giving my all to you.
Yo, what's up? It's your boy Aaron Cole. I'm coming to a big night in RVA. I'm coming to Richmond, Virginia for New Year's Eve, man. We bringing in the new year and VA, two up, two down. I can't wait to see you there. It's going to be free for youth and young adults, food, games, and more. So if you want more information, go to faithlandmarks.org. I can't wait to see you there. Peace.
Glad that you joined us today on Contact, and we want to invite you to come back again on Contact. However you arrived on this site, you can just make your way back, and we want to let you know that we bless you and we thank God for you, and we welcome you to come back in the mighty name of Jesus.